happy birthday.
You right now. When sound
when we violate the principle of the orbits of electrons in an atom, nuclear bombs and explosions take place. And when our parents, Adam and Eve, violated the principle of God, the consequence was severe. Separated us from God. But God the Father is a God of principle. Amen. And so God had to show us over and over again his principle. And like so many human fathers, it's often hard to see the heart of the Father. Amen. When the Father says, you can't go there on prom night. You can't go there on graduation night. It's hard to understand how much the Father loves. So God sent the second dispensation, the Son. And the Son had two missions. The first mission was to show us the heart of the Father. We didn't understand when the Father kicked us out of Eden. We didn't understand when he put a guard at the gate. We didn't understand when he said that our sins had suffered. We didn't understand. So the Son came. And the Son said, I'm going to show you the Father. And he told us about a farmer. He said, now which of you farmers, if you had 100 sheep, if one of them went astray, would leave that 100 and that 99 and go for that one, and not one person raise their hand? Because no one would leave 99 sheep to go save one sheep. But God the Father. God the Father would put everything God has on the line to save that one sheep. Dead and wanted his inheritance while you still are alive. Which of you would give that son that inheritance? Not one hand went up. He said, God the Father will do it. And even if you take that inheritance and you waste it on riotous living, God the Father will stay with you and he'll look every day watching for you and hoping and praying for you. And when he sees you alone,
muscles than I have, but he fell
in these cold hearts of ours. The second sign of the Holy Spirit of Pentecost is unity and diversity. Still reading from Acts chapter 2, verse 5. And there were dwelling in Jerusalem Jews, devout men from every nation under heaven. And when this sound occurred, the multitude came together and were confounded, because everyone heard them speak in his own language. This sound of unity in diversity. They're all speaking different languages. Some were speaking German and French and Hebrew and Latin and all kinds of languages. And everybody heard them and understood them and gave God glory. But we need to understand that they were very divided. The early church was very divided. By that I'm saying they believed different things. You know, it took them 100 years to come up with the Apostles' Creed. For 100 years, they could not understand the Apostles' Creed. For 100 years, they had differences on all kinds of things. Or they didn't understand the Trinity. Took them about 300 years to work out the Nicene Creed. They still argued over the virgin birth. They argued over the divinity of Jesus. They argued over the role of the Holy Spirit. They argued over which writings were inspired and which writings were not inspired. They argued over the role of women. They argued over the spiritual gifts. They argued over whether you should eat food, sacrifice to idols or not. They argued over whether the resurrection was bodily or spiritually or some combination of the two. They argued over how saved a person was if they sinned after they had been received salvation. They argued over the role of circumcision, the role of baptism. They even argued over whether we should be baptized from the dead. And with all that confusion, with all that division, they came up with three words that they all agreed on. And those three words were, Jesus is Lord. You might not baptize the way I do, but Jesus is Lord. You might not have the same kind of worship I have, but Jesus is Lord. And what I want us to understand, that one of the most powerful things we can ever hear is that voice of unity and diversity. What is the language of unity and diversity? It is the language of love. You know, God does some crazy things now. God will take a husband and wife and make one from Mars and the other from Venus. One will be a spender, one will be a saver. One will be an extrovert, one will be an introvert. One will be a professional person. That one, you just got to take me to where I am. They don't fight. They don't have problems. Because love covers a multitude of sins. And when we get that kind of love, it doesn't matter if your neighbor agrees with you in the board meeting. It doesn't matter. the sound of the preaching of the good news.
Amen.
Verse 14, same chapter. But Peter, standing up with the 11, raised his voice and said to them, "Men of Judea and all who dwell in Jerusalem, let this be known to you, and heed my words, for there are not drunk as you suppose, since it is only the third hour of the day. But this is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel."
Amen.
Up until that point, no one in the church had preached a sermon. The church had just been born. And Peter stands up, the same Peter that denied the Lord three times, he stands up.
Yes.
And he preaches the first Holy Ghost sermon. And 3,000 souls got saved. When we were at our meeting yesterday, the Christian education meeting, someone stood up and said, well, elder, what do we do if our church is dead? And the elder threw this instead.
Thank you.
woman of God in his home. And Father, bless the food we're about to receive, that it be nourishment for our bodies. In Jesus' name.